Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to make a simple black and white logo from three letters using negative and positive space. You can apply these techniques to any odd number of characters, 3, 5, 7, and so on. I'll also show you how to make an alternate version near the end. Make a new document by going to File and New. Type in 1280 by 720 pixels and a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. To fit it onto your screen, press Ctrl+0 on a PC or Command+0 on a Mac. Press Ctrl or Command+J to make a copy of it. We'll fill the copy with a medium gray. Press Shift plus F5. Choose 50% gray and click OK. Go to View and make sure Rulers and Snap are checked. If they're not, just click on them. Go to the top ruler and drag out a guideline to approximately the lower third of your document. Open your Horizontal Type tool and choose a thick, heavy font. I'm using Air Cruiser, which you can download from abstractfonts.com. If you're not sure how to install fonts, watch my tutorial on how to do this. Its link is located in the video's description. I'll choose a size of 225 points, none for the anti-aliasing method, left for the alignment, and black for the color. Type your first letter and click on your Move tool. We'll make two copies of it, since we'll be using three letters for this logo. Press Ctrl or Command+J twice. Check Auto Select. This automatically selects the layers associated with the objects you click on, so you don't have to click on the actual layers in order to make them active. Make sure each character snaps to the guideline. Click on the middle letter to make it active, and press T to open your Type tool. Click on the color box, pick White, click OK, highlight the letter, and type in the new letter you want. Make the third letter of your logo active, highlight it, and type in the new third letter. Open your Move tool, go to the top ruler, and drag a guideline down until it snaps to the top of the letters. Drag all the letters until they snap together. Make the gray layer active and click on the New Layer button to make a new layer above it. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and go to the top left of your first letter and drag a rectangular selection to the bottom right of your last letter. The top and bottom will snap to the guidelines, however the sides don't have to be exact. Open your Pencil tool and make the size approximately 30 pixels and a hardness of 100%. With white as your foreground color, if there's a black curve at the point where two letters meet, paint in that area of the gray background with white. Conversely, if there's a white curve at the point where two letters meet, paint in that area of the gray background with black. Invert the colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Now, paint over the curved areas with black, as well as the areas in the middle. Hide the gray layer and delete the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command plus D. Hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command plus H. Open your Channels panel and click on the circular dotted button. This makes a selection of all the tonal values in your image. Open back up your Layers panel and make the top layer active. Click on the New Layer button to make a new layer above it. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command+Shift+I. We'll fill the selection with black, and since black is the background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Now we can delete the selection. Now that we have the text of the logo on a separate layer, we can hide all of the layers that comprised it. Open your Move tool to reposition it. If you want to skew the entire logo, press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool, go to the top middle point, and press and hold Ctrl Shift Alt on a PC or Command Shift Option on a Mac and drag it to the right. Then press Enter or Return. Let's add a soft drop shadow in perspective. Ctrl click or Command click on the thumbnail to make a selection of the logo's shape. Click on the New Layer button to make a new layer. Click on the foreground color and type in 80% for brightness. Then click OK. Fill it with this foreground color and delete the selection. Drag this layer below the black logo. Open your Transform tool, go to the top middle point, and press and hold Alt on a PC or Option on a Mac and drag it down and over to an angle you like. Then press Enter or Return. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 3 pixels. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag out a rectangle across the entire shadow and approximately 2/3 up. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 30 pixels. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur, and this time, blur it 7 pixels. Then delete the selection. Make your foreground and background colors default to black and white. To do this, click on the small black and white overlapping box icon or press D on your keyboard. Invert it by pressing the curved double arrow or by pressing X. With white as your foreground color, open your brush tool and make the size 200 pixels, the hardness 0%, and the opacity 50%. Press F5 to open your brush presets and make sure the only box that's checked is smoothing. Press F5 again to close the window. Press and hold Shift as you drag your brush across the bottom half of the shadow to lighten it. Next, I'll show you how to make this alternate design. Hide the shadow layer and make your black logo active. Open your Transform tool, and when you see a straight double arrow, press and hold Shift and Alt on a PC or Shift and Option on a Mac and drag it in a little to reduce its size. Then press Enter or Return. Go to the New Layer button and press and hold Ctrl or Command as you click down on it. This creates a new layer below the active layer. Fill it with black and open your Elliptical Marquee tool. Go to the center and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag out an ellipse. To cut it out from the black background, press Ctrl or Command J. Hide the black background and make your logo active. Invert the colors by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Make the ellipse active and open your Transform tool. Go to a corner and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it counterclockwise. Click inside the Transform to reposition it. When you're happy with the angle, position, and size, press Enter or Return. Using these simple techniques, you can create simple but striking logos just from the shapes of letters. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.